today's video, I'm going to show you how to create brand imagery in Canva using styled stock from Etsy Stock Shop. And I don't just mean in the common sense way, like slapping text on top of your styled stock imagery, which is super important and helpful and useful, but I want to show you how I actually add in shadowing, how I create pinnable images in a pinch, and even how I add in my own handwriting into these images without even opening Adobe. Hey guys, welcome to another episode. My name is Ashlyn Carter. I am the calligrapher and copywriter behind the brand Ashlyn Writes. I help creative entrepreneurs and women like you sell more with your words so you can work from a place of rest, not hustle, but today we're actually talking about imagery. Imagery is so, so important when it comes to communicating your overall marketing and messaging strategy. Now, I am no photographer, as you've probably noticed, and every single time that I try, and boy, I try, to take my styled stock imagery or flat lays here in my office, they're just not quite that great. Even when I try to use Lightroom and different hacks, I'm not a photographer. It's not my thing, so I have to outsource it. My favorite resource has been Etsy Stock Shop for various reasons. Primarily, though, they are huge graphics, so you can get really tight zooms and crops on them, which I'm going to show you when we move over to the computer to look at this in Canva. I like that, and I also like that her whites are actually really white, so I have an easier time matching imagery across different, you know, looks and different brand stylings that I want to show off in my business. So that's been super helpful for me. I will link it below if you're interested in looking at her different items in the shop. So let's go ahead and hop into the computer. Before I do that, I do want to say, so I am a calligrapher, which means I digitize a ton of my artwork and I lay out a lot of different invitation suites. I know Adobe like the back of my hand, but I use Canva when it comes to a lot of different things in my business, sheerly because it just moves so much quicker. It is fast, it is so easy. The files are a lot less bulky and small, so it takes less time to export them and use them in other ways. I wanna show you how to use Canva to create different brand imagery using your Etsy Stock Shop images. All right, here we are on the computer. I'm gonna go ahead and pop open Canva, voila. Here it is. Now, I was pretty tempted to like go ahead and hop in here and like clean up my account for you, but I thought, let's just show you the whole shebang. It's like Hot Mess Express in here. I'm sure there are fantastic organization videos out there on the internets about sorting all this using foldering. I'm gonna be honest, I just find things a heck of a lot faster if I just pop in here. So the first thing I wanna show you is just how to create a digital mock-up with your images. So we're just gonna pop over here. I have my templates already laid out. This is what we use for Pinterest primarily. So, yep. Gang's all here. Okay, and let's just say I wanna make an image that have the background be one of my styled stock images, and I wanna show off a document on an iPad. So I'm just gonna go ahead and clear this out so we have like a fresh space to work on. I also like in Canva, you can set up like your brand colors, your document colors, and your fonts. If you're not familiar with Canva, I would get familiar with it. It's just fabulous. So let's go ahead and add in a background image. Over here, these are all the different folders for imagery that we have in Canva, not just like anything that we have over in the Dropbox. We kind of import in here the things that we typically use to work in Canva. So let's just pick an image. I like this guy. I'm gonna make it big and scoot it way over because I wanna show off, let's say I wanna show off a download that I have that I want people to grab. So I love being able to have mockups. Now, one of the things that you need to watch for is size. You know, that looks like a little teacup next to, that looks a little bit better next to this iPad. So one thing you do, just wanna always make sure that your size is on point. So there, boom, good to go. Now let's add in an image. I do have an entire folder just with random images that we've used for opt-ins, which I found pretty helpful when I do this. Tweak it a little bit, pull it over here. Oh, it's pretty far off on that. There, that's better. All right, now one thing I wanna show you, and this is kind of far on the side, and I'm like not really sure how I came up with this or if I saw this somewhere. I'm gonna be honest, I have no idea, but I've been doing it and I really like it, and it's called the triangle trick. So to do the triangle trick, it just makes things look a little more real. You pop over to Elements, open up shapes and grab this triangle guy. Where is he there? That's not the one I like. What is this? Who did well in geometry growing up? Isosceles maybe? Whatever. Dye him white. And I'm gonna pop it over here. All right.
Like, that's probably good enough. Nope, it's definitely not. But, okay. And the trick is to do a little bit of this action. Okay, so all I did there was go over to the transparency of it and pull it way down. And there's not really a magic number. It just kind of depends on what this image is and everything all together, but that just makes things look a little more real. So there you have it, the triangle trick. And you can also use that. So let's say, and the beauty of the style stock too, let me interrupt myself for a moment, is say I wanted to like sub this out for something else. Let's pick, let's do this one. You know, I could do something like this. See if I can cover those up. Well, actually I can, so you would want to shrink that down. See how that works? And I would obviously want to pull this over. You get what I'm saying. You can pop in and out different images until you find the look that you want. I did not edit this professionally. So that would be how you do like an iPad or a iPhone or any kind of small portable object. Well, let's say you want to use one of Shay's desktop images, then you can still do that triangle trick that I just taught you. I would add in like a screenshot back here, delete this madness, and you would just do the similar effect. You get what I'm saying? All right, so that is how you do like a digital mock-up. Maybe you want to use that for your client magazines or your shop product downloads that are digital, anything like that. That's how you're going to show that off. But let's say that you want to show something that's like a hard copy. So how do you do that? Well, you don't use the triangle trick, you use something else. So let's pick another pretty image. Here we go, this guy can work. This is a shop item. So we'll move that again, making sure sizing, stamps to paper ratio, looking kind of on point. So we'll go with that. And then instead of the triangle trick over here, you're gonna use the rectangle trick. Not as great alliteration, still fantastic. So you'll find the square. This time I'm gonna make it gray. The beauty is that you wanna make it about the same size as the paper that you're trying to mimic. And then you just want to send it back. So you can go over to arrange. You can also click on the image and do that. And I need to match it a little better. And I'm gonna use my arrow keys to get it just precise. I don't want it too much. Yeah, that looks pretty good. So let me see if I can grab it again. And you bring, again, the transparency down. So let's see if that looks good. Yeah, not bad. I would probably even make it actually even more transparent. So I'm gonna pause here and remind you that this is how you create those killer Pinterest graphics that get tons and tons of repins and downloads because you're showing off an opt-in or a freebie or just a shop item that is tangible instead of just digital, and that can be really helpful. So let's say one other way you can use this, I've kind of showed it off in a Pinterest format, but one thing that as a copywriter, I always want to tell people that it's so very important to communicate what you do visually alongside your words, right? Copy dictates design, but at the same time, it's the image that kind of hooks somebody. So let's say that you want to demonstrate part of your client process, maybe that right after they start working with you, they get your welcome magazine and blah, 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 how great that is. So one way that you can show that is hopping over to maybe I want a square size image on my website. So I'm going to go ahead and pick an image from the shop. I liked this one from the collaboration that she did with, again, Sweet Megan. Okay, that looks pretty good. So this is going to be for some website imagery to illustrate my client process. So what I'm going to do to kind of grab those images of our client magazine is just do a quick screenshot. So let's do that. So these are uploading these screenshots. Here we go. So shrink it down, make sure the size is ish. Be a little bigger. There we go. Always tilt. And this guy. And now I need these pages to match up in size. So here we go. All right. This is page 2 of our client magazine. Just gonna give it a little bit of tilt. That may be too much, but I want some of the text to show because I'm gonna arrange this to the back. Okay, there we go. The rectangle trick will come into play here. I'd go with that. That looks a little more real life. And I'd probably pop one behind the sky too, just to give it a little more depth and texture. And that is how it's done.
So to take a picture of my handwriting, I pop over to an app called Union. Projects. See, I do this all the time. All right. For the background, we want to hit blank. That's a good enough size. So I'm going to click yes. Pop over to foreground. This is where I want to pull in this guy. And make him pretty big. Yep, that works. And mask. So I clicked the erase option. Let me show you that one more time. So you have these three options. I clicked erase. And I had the magic wand selected. And I'm just going to go in and clear out all this little riffraff that's running around in here. Let's get that guy. And all right, that's good enough. Okay, so yeah, we're pretty much ready. So now I'm just gonna export it and I save it to my Canva roll and I drop it into any kind of app where I can share it with my computer.
So say you wanna make a quick social media image with the handwriting that I just showed you how to use. We'll pop over. Social Squares is Etsy Stock Shop's social media sized images. So these are a lot smaller than those big old guys that you can use and do that really tight zoom crop on. But let's just say we need a quick image for something to post on social media. Let's see, I want this one. And I'll go through the checkout process really quickly. Okay, I'm just gonna download it. Great, comes in a zip, open. Sweet. Like I showed you earlier, let's just do a social media sized image. Perfect. That's what we want. I'll pull over this. Boom. Perfect. And now that I've imported that handwriting picture I had, where did I put that? Perfect. Okay, and that's uploading. And great. And it already has that transparent background, which is exactly what we wanted, which is why I love the Union app. So let's see if we can pull this in. There it is. Perfect. Yeah, there you go. That is exactly how it is done.
That is how I use Etsy Stock Shop images in Canva to create different brand imagery for my business. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and I'll be back next week with an all new video to help you out.